Breaking news. Federal High Court hears Nnamdi Kanu's application challenging trial. You're welcome to the news. Kindly listen to the details. The Federal High Court in Abuja is hearing the application of the leader of indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu, challenging the propriety of his trial as well as competence of the charge against him. Justice Binta Onyeako had adjourned the hearing to 16 February 2022 after Mr. Kanu pleaded not guilty to the amended 15-count charges of terrorism brought against him by the federal government. Nnamdi Kanu had claimed that the charges, which he denied upon arraignment, were incurably defective and have no force of law. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu had made his application challenging trial and the court was willing to hear him. The court, after Nnamdi Kanu pleaded not guilty to whatever charges that was given to him, and because of that, the Justice Binta Onyeako had to rearrange his trial again. His trial has been adjourned to the 8th day of April 2022. Fresh evidences emerges in Nnamdi Kanu's case. One of the siblings of Nnamdi Kanu, leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, on Wednesday, claimed that his brother is still technically in Kenya from the new evidence. It has been reported that although Prince Kanu Meme did not elaborate on the new evidence, it apparently has to do with the IPOB leader's controversial arrest in Kenya in June last year, and his subsequent transfer to Nigeria. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is technically in Kenya from the new evidence, Kanu's brother wrote on his known Facebook page. A 15-count terrorism charge was slammed on Nnamdi Kanu by the federal government. He pleaded not guilty to the charges and asked the federal government and asked the Federal High Court, Abuja, to discharge and acquit him without standing trial because the charges were not worth being defended. Kanu had last Tuesday filed a preliminary objection challenging the competence of the new charge as well as the jurisdiction of the court to hear the matter. According to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, the fresh charge preferred against him were baseless, worthless, defective, and could not stand the test of the law, hence should be dismissed. Kanu was detained for 8 days in Kenya before his repatriation to Nigeria to continue his trial before Justice Binta Onyeako led federal government. Upon his return, Kanu was slammed with charges bordering on terrorism. But it is technically known that Kanu is still in Kenya and not in Nigeria. And now, the Kenya government had made it known to the public, to the media, that there was no immigration record of Nnamdi Kanu's departure from the country, Kenya. Mr. Alan Ejimakọ, special counsel to the detained leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, has said that the Kenyan government had filed a document in court to show that there was no immigration record of Kanu's departure from Kenya after his arrival to the court on May 12, 2021. a release jointly issued by Ejimakor and the IPOB leader's brother, Kanu Takano, argued that the position of the Kenyan government amid the circumstances under which Kanu disappeared from Kenya a more grievous offense, claiming that serious consequences await all those involved in the action. In the latest affidavit filed by the Kenyan government in defense of the suit filed by Mercy Onwuamdi Kanu in Kenya, it asserted that there was no immigration record of Kanu's departure from Kenya after his last arrival on 12th May 2021. The release made available reads in part, in the affidavit drawn up and filed by the Attorney General of Kenya and deposed to in Nairobi, Kenya on 10th February 2022, the government of Kenya attached Kanu's arrival and departure record from Kenya from 17th July 2019 to 12th May 2022 when he last entered Kenya. Paragraph 12 of the affidavit stated that it is evident from the schedule below that since 17th of July 2019, the said Mercy Onwuamdi Kanu has visited and departed Kenya on several occasions. Paragraph 13 of the affidavit states that from the above travel history, it is evident that his last arrival date was May 12, 2021. And there is no evidence exhibited to prove that he thereafter left the country. Paragraph 14 of the affidavit stated that I am not privy to his Kanu's arrest, detention or extradition. Kanu's lawyers argue that it is pertinent to note that this affidavit have been drawn up and filed by the Attorney General of Kenya is the clearest official confirmation yet from the government of Kenya that what happened to Nnamdi Kanu in Kenya amounts to a crime, both in Nigeria, Kenya, and under international law. With this latest development, Kanu's ordeal in Kenya has turned to a newcomer, where domestic and international criminal indictments rely against the persons that directly or indirectly participated in this high crime. It has gone beyond extraordinary rendition. The case, the extradition of Mercy Onwuamdi Kanu, has gone beyond extraordinary rendition. Now the Kenya government as is saying that the last time Onwuamdi Kanu came to Kenya, he has not departed Kenya. So how come the Nigeria government is saying that he was extradited from Kenya to Nigeria? Thank you once again. Enjoy the rest of your day.